Everybody, are you ready for the very best news in the world? Everybody, are you ready? It's a gift for every boy and girl. Yeah, everybody all around the world. We know God loved us so much. He sent us His Son, we're singing.
Jesus is God's Son, let's celebrate.
Everybody come on, sing and shout it. Everybody tell the world about it.
Jesus is God's Son, yeah, He's so great.
Everybody come on, sing and shout it. Friends about what God has done. It's amazing, so exciting. It's big enough for all who wanna come. Yeah, everybody join a happy song. Because God loved us so much, He sent us His Son. We're singing.
Jesus is God's Son, let's celebrate.
Everybody come on, sing and shout.
I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Joy down in my soul to stay, and nothing's gonna take it away. Joy down in my soul, I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Whatever comes my way, I'll be okay. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Joy down in my soul to stay, and nothing's gonna take it away. Joy down in my soul, I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Whatever comes my way, I'll be okay. I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Joy down in my soul to stay, and nothing's gonna take it away. Joy down in my soul, I'm gonna let this feeling take control. Whatever comes my way, I'll be okay.
Sunrise, gonna fix my eyes on the one who never fails. I'm gonna
gonna make some noise, cause you give me joy, and it's never ever going away. Every new sunrise, gonna fix my eyes on the one who never fails. I'm gonna make some noise, cause you give me joy, and it's never ever going away. Whoa, whoa.
Cause I've got joy.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let her receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing.
Open your Bibles to Luke chapter 1, verse 26 through 56. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end. How will this be? Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin. The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who is said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your word to me be fulfilled. Then the angel left her. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill her promises to her." And Mary said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name. His mercy extends to those who fear him from generation to generation. He has performed mighty deeds with his arms. He has scattered those who are proud in their inmost thoughts. He has brought down rulers from their thrones, but has lifted up the humble. He has filled the hungry with good things, but has sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel, remembering to be merciful to Abraham and his descendants forever, just as he promised our ancestors." Mary stayed with Elizabeth for about 3 months and then returned home.
It's me, Jacob.
Sorry if it seems like I'm in a rush. Gotta make this quick, cause it's the holidays. You know what that means? Lots of plans on the old calendar.
I got something happening every single day leading up to the big day.
Christmas! Christmas is celebrating Jesus, God's greatest gift. So, let me see if there's anything new in this big wrapped box. And then I can get busy celebrating. Here we go.
No way.
This is what Christmas is all about, right here. Ginger spiced pecan with a hint of nutmeg, some oregano mixed in just for a little flavor, and sprinkled on top with chocolate sprinkles. And then we mix in some of Aunt Dori's famous protein powder just to build the muscle. Non-dairy, gluten-free, if you can believe it, Dori can make it. And I'm sensing a hint of chocolate now. She's mixing up. She's gone off the grid. She's mixing up the recipe. It smells so good. But the taste, oh! I don't have the words to describe the taste of Aunt Dori's famous pie. I'm gonna need to set this down for a second. My family's been going to Aunt Dori's at Christmas time ever since I was a little kid. That's always been the plan. I get to hang out with my cousins and catch up on old times. We always eat the biggest meal. You never saw so many casseroles. But if your belly's smart, it always saves room for the pie. Sorry. Come on, Jacob, get it together. I'm getting distracted by pie. Sorry. This year, we had to change the plan a little bit. Aunt Dori hasn't been feeling too well, and the family thought it'd be best if we wait until she's feeling better before we get together. It's kind of a bummer when plans don't go the way you'd expect, but we're trying to make the best of things. Find things to be joyful about, you know? Hey, the story today is about changing plans. This girl, Mary, she had to change her plans, not just for the holidays, but for her whole life. And do you think she was able to be joyful? We'll find out in just a minute. I think I'll stick around for the story. And the pie. Maybe just some pie, just a little bit of pie.
The Bible, it's 66 books of history, stories, letters, and poetry that fit together to form God's one big story. The epic adventure of how he created us and loves us so much that he made a way to rescue us. As we travel through the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, we discover people who met God and found their lives changed forever. Now, for an amazing story, inspired by the book of Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 56.
Mary lived in the tiny town of Nazareth, an ordinary village at the edge of Jewish lands.
Nazareth? Can anything good come from there?
Mary herself was an ordinary girl.
Oh, hello.
She grew up learning the Jewish scriptures.
A child will be born to us, a son will be given to us, he will rule over us, and he will be called Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God. When will this happen?
Only God knows. It's been hundreds of years.
Mary went to fetch water from the well and baked loaves of bread and swept out the hard-packed earth floor.
It's important to clean the dirt off the dirt.
She was also engaged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph. Mary must have expected that her life would follow a very ordinary path until one day when everything changed.
Greetings, Mary.
Suddenly, right there in the dim room, a brilliant being appeared. Mary probably dropped whatever she was holding, a broom, a batch of bread dough, a needle and thread.
Who? Me?
The Lord has blessed you in a special way. He is with you.
Mary blinked, trying to take it all in. The whole room glowed with light.
I don't understand.
Do not be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you.
Mary couldn't find any words. In one heartbeat, her very ordinary day had flipped upside down.
You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. He will rule forever over his people. That kingdom will never end.
The words of Isaiah may have echoed in Mary's head.
A child will be born to us. A son will be given to us. He will rule over us.
She finally found her voice.
How can this happen? I'm not even married yet.
The light flared even brighter.
The Holy Spirit will make this happen. Your relative Elizabeth will have a child even though she is old. People thought she could not have children, but she has been pregnant for 6 months now. That's because what God says will always come true.
Mary's heart pounded. Her cousin Elizabeth was old enough to be a grandmother, and if she was having a baby, anything could happen.
I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would.
The light faded. The towering angel disappeared. Mary leaned against the wall to collect her thoughts.
Elizabeth, I have to go see her.
The journey to Elizabeth and Zechariah's home in the hill country of Judah would have taken many days of travel along dusty roads. Finally, Mary arrived.
Why, it's Mary.
Elizabeth, I have so much to tell you.
As Mary spoke, Elizabeth could feel the child inside of her leap and kick for joy. God's Holy Spirit spoke to Elizabeth.
God has blessed you more than other women, and blessed is the child you will have. As soon as I heard the sound of your voice, the baby inside of me jumped for joy. You are a woman God has blessed. You have believed that the Lord would keep his promises to you.
Mary laughed and cried at the same time as she hugged her older cousin. God confirmed once again that Mary could find joy in the extraordinary plan God had for her.
Now tell me your story.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth for several weeks. She was so filled with joy, she poured out her heart in a song to God.
My soul gives glory to the Lord. My spirit delights in God, my Savior. He has taken note of me, even though I'm not considered important. He shows his mercy to those who have respect for him. He has filled with good things those who are hungry. He has helped the people of Israel who serve him. He has done it just as he had promised to our people of long ago.
At the end of 3 months, Mary returned home to Nazareth, ready to see how God's plan was about to unfold.
I can't believe I just ate that whole pie. Almost the whole pie. That was not part of the plan. But hey, I definitely felt the joy. Maybe you're like me, and your plans had to change for some reason this season. Reason season. I rhymed that on purpose. Nah, I'm just teasing. It is totally okay to feel sad when plans don't go the way you expect. I'm sad I don't get to go to Aunt Dori's. But, like Aunt Dori says, you don't have to dwell on the sadness. You don't have to stay sad forever. There could be a bigger reason why plans change. Think about it. Before God revealed his plan, Mary was just like any one of us. She had her own hopes and dreams for the future, just like we do. But her plans changed because God had a bigger plan for her. It's the same with us. My plans, God's plans. God knows everything that's ever happened, and he knows everything that's going to happen. So, he has a plan for you. It may be different than your plan, but trust me, it's a bigger and better plan. So, if you're sad when plans change, that's okay. Just don't dwell there. You can have joy knowing that your plans are in bigger hands. Plans hands. That sort of rhymes. Here's the one thing to remember today. You can have joy because God has a plan for you. It's cool to think that the creator of the universe has a plan just for me. I don't know about you, but that makes me kind of, also kind of excited. Huh. And kind of hungry. One more slice of pie won't hurt. Oh, looks like the plans are changing again. Oh boy, the plans are changing fast. I'll catch you next time.
Last week, we talked about the big promise God made to his people that he would one day send a savior. As Jesus' mom, Mary got to play a super important part in God's story. She must have been scared when the angel first appeared. But in the end, she chose to trust God. She chose to have joy. As we see how God's big story unfolded over time, it reminds us that we can trust God no matter what. We can trust that he has a good plan for our lives, and knowing that can bring us real joy. You can have joy because God has a plan for you. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you for loving us. Thank you for having a good plan for our lives. Just like you had a plan for Mary, you have a plan for each one of us. Help us remember that as we live each day, help us to find joy because we know you're at work in our lives. We love you and we pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Let's say this month's memory verse together. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Luke chapter 2, verse 11.
Almost there. Here we go.
What is this again, John?
Well, you know how I like to ice sculpt?
No, I did not know that.
I talk about it all the time.
No.
Okay, well, anyway, I made an 8-foot-tall Christmas tree, which is an exact replica of the 77-foot-tall Christmas tree in Rockefeller Center in New York City.
Wouldn't that just be like a regular Christmas tree?
No, you're missing the point. I carved the tree out of an ice block with a chainsaw.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, now that does sound amazing.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah,
can you take the blindfold off now?
All right, take a deep breath.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And prepare to be amazed. Where is it? It was right here. It was. I spent many hours on it. It was perfect. It had like individual branches, individual lights on it. It even had a star on top. Somebody stole my ice sculpture. Oh. I found it.
This isn't peppermint spice. It's pumpkin cream.
Go.
What?
Go.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the So-and-So Show. We are your hosts, Brandon.
And John, and a very merry almost Christmas to you all.
Yes, indeed. We are so excited that it's December again, and we get to revisit some of our favorite Bible stories, eat lots of fruitcake, and sing carols off-pitch for our neighbors.
Yeah. Deck the halls with boughs of holly. La 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 la.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah, that was so much fun last year. Hey, you know what? I'm going to go ahead and pencil that in for, say, next Thursday at 2:27 p.m.
Oh, that's specific.
Yeah, well, there's lots of holiday plans, my friend. You got to squeeze them all in there.
Okay, well, I guess it's a plan.
You guess?
Yeah, sure.
You better be sure. My time here is precious, buddy. This is Christmas. This calendar fills up fast and full. Oh. Look, see?
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah, ooh, I see that.
Good, because tomorrow... Look at this. Tomorrow, I'm making gingerbread houses with my nieces, then off to the homeless shelter to hand out Christmas scarves, then I'm helping my mom decorate her Christmas tree before I go grocery shopping for the annual family Christmas bake-off, which is the next day. And the bake-off is always a 24-hour event, so there will be no sleeping that night, and then I have only 45 minutes the day after that for a little nap before the Christmas train leaves the station again.
You're going on a train?
It's a metaphorical train, Brandon, and it doesn't stop till New Year's Eve! I love Christmas.
If I may speak freely.
Sure, you have 23 seconds.
Okay, it seems like your calendar is a little overstuffed.
Yeah, what do you mean?
Like, how are you going to enjoy all of the things this month if every minute is filled with some type of plan?
Christmas plan. That's what Christmas is all about. It's about having Christmas all month long.
Okay, but still, I don't think it's what Christmas is all about. There's other
Time's things. Up! Please welcome someone who knows stuff.
What? We aren't expecting a guest today.
I know, I didn't have time to schedule a visit with my aunt and my uncle, so just make the best of it, okay? Hey! Aunt Irene and Uncle Jim, welcome to the show!
Oh, thank you, John. Yeah. Your studio is lovely.
This is Brandon, my co-host.
Oh, hi, Brandon.
Oh, it sure is good finally meeting you, Brandon. We love watching the show.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yes. Oh, Merry Christmas to you both.
Merry Christmas to you all. Hey, have a seat. Okay, right here. Yeah. That's great.
Right there.
No, right here. There you go. And you're right here. And Uncle Jim. Okay, that's great. Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Okay, tell us who you are and what you know.
Well, we are your Aunt Irene.
Yeah.
And?
Oh, and I'm Uncle Jim.
Yeah, we covered that.
And I don't know what we know. Well, I know we love you, John.
Yeah.
Oh, and I know all about raised bed herb gardening.
And that is all the time we have for today. Hey, thanks for coming on the show, you guys. It was great seeing you.
Oh, but we just got here.
Yeah, come on, John. Don't be rude.
I'm not being rude. I'm just trying not to cut into Kellen's time. Oh, that's it.
What?
It's Bible story time with Kellen!
Hello, everybody.
Hey, Kellen.
I hope you need help telling the Bible story today, Kellen.
I think the So-and-So Show players have it covered this week.
Not anymore. It's time for the dynamic stylings of my Uncle Jim and Aunt Irene.
Hi, Kellen.
I'm an angel.
Okay, this should be fun. Here we go. Aunt Irene and Uncle Jim in the story of Mary and the angel. And you can find this story in the Gospel of Luke. Around 2,000 years ago, God sent an angel named Gabriel to the town of Nazareth.
Hello. I've got a message from God for a girl named Mary.
Mary was engaged to Joseph, and Joseph came from the family line of King David.
Mary.
Oh, hello. Who are you?
The Lord has blessed you in a special way. He is with you.
How exciting.
Mary was actually very frightened when Gabriel appeared to her.
Oh, okay. Ah! How terrifying. Oh.
Say, that was really good.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah, I do. I really felt your fear.
Oh, thank you.
But do not be afraid, Mary, for God is very pleased with you. And you will get pregnant and have a son. And you must call him Jesus. And he will be called the Son of the Most High God. And his kingdom will never end.
How can this happen? I am not married.
The Holy Spirit will come to you. And the power of the Most High God will cover you. Oh, wow. That's really something, ain't it? I guess God can do anything, right, Kellen?
Yeah. In fact, one of Mary's own relatives, Elizabeth, was also going to have a baby, even though everyone thought she was too old.
Oh, that's amazing. What God says will always come true. So, what do you think, Mary?
I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would.
After that, the angel left her.
Oh, okay then. See ya.
Now, Mary really wanted to share her news with someone, so she went to see Elizabeth. The baby in Elizabeth's belly jumped for joy when Mary arrived. And Elizabeth told Mary, God has blessed you and the child you will have. You believe the Lord's promises. And then, Mary said,
My soul gives glory to the Lord. My spirit delights in God, my Savior. Will we keep going?
Thanks, Aunt Irene, but that'll do. Mary may have been afraid of what was going to happen. She may have been overwhelmed with all the planning she had to do to prepare for a new baby in her life. But she was able to find joy in it. And she took the time to praise God for being faithful to her and her people and for always keeping his promises. The end.
That was incredible.
Yeah, great job, Aunt Irene and Uncle Jim.
Oh, thank you.
Hey.
Yeah. Oh, and thanks to you too, Kellen.
Nah, don't even mention it. What'd you guys think of the story?
I loved it. An angel appearing to someone, that's always epic.
I liked how Mary was willing to trust God even when things seemed impossible.
Oh, and I like the song.
Oh, stop it. Oh.
It was great meeting you both, and thank you so much for your help with the Bible story.
You bet.
Yeah.
I'll see you guys next time.
Bye, Kellen. Bye, Kellen.
Oh, we better get going, too. Yeah. Lots of plans for the holidays, yeah. You know.
Wait. Can you guys stay a little longer? I've really enjoyed having you here.
Well. Are you sure, John? I mean, you seem awfully busy.
I am. I mean, I was. Oh. Hey, looks like my schedule opened up.
Well.
Hello. Okay, then.
Yeah, twist my arm.
All right, come on over. It's Christmas. I don't want to get so busy with all my plans that I forget to enjoy any of them.
Oh. That sounds like a plan.
Yeah, you know what my plan is right now? Let's sing Christmas carols out of tune.
All right, here. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Oh, beautiful.
Horrible. Reveal the question. What are your plans for Christmas?
Yeah, what have you got on your calendar this year? Decorating a tree, maybe?
Or baking cookies?
Or visiting family.
Yeah.
Talk about it with each other. What are your plans for Christmas?
And we'll see you next time on The So-and-So Show!
All right, jingle bells again, ready?
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
It's hard to sing the harmony when you're all...
I was singing the harmony.
You start.
Oh, you're singing the harmony?
I was singing the harmony,
Oh, yeah. You sing it then.
Oh, I was just.
I thought I was.
Oh, you were?
No.
Maybe.
Oh,
maybe
you go ahead.